You know the times when you just sit very comfortable in your sofa and realize and decide that you want to switch to another game, and you have to go pick out your game, pick out the cartridge, switch it up before you can get back in the sofa and play again. It would be so easier if you just had a little box where you can store all the cartridges. So that's what I made. I just had one problem. I printed it a little bit too small for the cartridges to fit. I should have thought of that before. So I made up a 3D model in Blender a little quick. Actually, it took around an hour and a half or something. You can check that out on my Blender channel up here. I took the file, converted it to be able to print it, and just printed it. So here is some video of that. This took about one day and 16 hours, I think. Looks really nice. Time to assemble it when I get it off the printing plate. Removed the support, so I started removing all the support pieces, both from the outside where the question mark needed some support, and a lot of support from the inside because I printed it like upside down, so that it's a big empty space in the middle of it, and the support needs to hold up the top of it, which actually made it a bit hard to get out all the support from inside the block itself. But I managed to get it all out in the end, even though it was quite hard. So away with all that plastic trash and get on with the other part. On this one there actually was a lot of small support of this like grid texture that was a bit hard to remove. It was now that I realized that the slots for the cartridges were a bit small, so I thought maybe I can sand it so that it gets a bit bigger, but I realized that it would take a lot of time to sand them enough. If you want to see my other 3D printing videos, you can check them out up here. So I decided to cut the border in between, so that there were a lot more of space and I didn't need to sand as much. But then it was a lot of sanding too, because parts of the border in between was still there, so I still needed sanding a lot. So I decided it looked a bit weird, so I decided to just cut a bigger hole to be able to fit my 8-bit do adapter there instead, which also is a thing that I need to go and reach for when I sit really comfortable in a sofa and don't want to get up. I also added these gold sticks to make the actual like drawer thing inside slide in a more controlled way and don't like fly up and down if you hold the block upside down. So then I began sanding the other slots up again to make those be able to fit the cartridges. I also took this paper and covered up the holes from where the screws are in the question block design, which I thought would be covered up in the print itself. I took a cardboard piece and covered up the big ugly hole that I cut up in the drawer thing earlier. Just place it in there, glue it and sand it a little bit. So I want to clean up the workplace a little bit before I begin sanding the different slots for the cartridges again, so that the cartridges would fit. I did this for like 3 hours more, something. I also painted the popsicle sticks inside and to make them fit with the design more. So now the cartridges fit pretty well and it's done. Place some of my games in there and put it next to my Switch. I easily could go and switch the cartridges when I wanted to play another game. It's really nice now actually. Don't need to get up and reach a drawer. Now you can just take the cartridge from the new holder and place it in the Switch. If you like this type of content, be sure to subscribe and watch some of my other videos right here. Also like the video if you enjoyed it.